You. Yes, you as whole. Listen carefully. Don't you dare skipping Astro Lost in Space. That's all I have to say. Let's roll the intro. So winter has officially ended and I am feeling kinda empty right now. Dororo was one of the best shows in recent years and that finale was satisfying. And Rising of the Shield Hero ended as well with no announcement of season 2. It was a decent isekai but the ending was really good and the show overall is enjoyable. Spring season as a whole was just whatever. Not many good or hype shows except Kimetsu no Yaiba and Attack on Titan. But now we are entering summer and boy it's so fucking hot right now that I need to take a shower thrice a day and I'm not even joking. Talking about hotness, we got some big dogs this season. Fire Force is one of the most hype shows right now. The studio behind the series is Devil Production, mostly known for JoJo. And this series will have 4 cores, which means approximately 50 episodes, which is worth a year. That's crazy. From the synopsis and the trailers we got, it looks really interesting and the animation is smooth as fuck, so I'm really looking forward to this series. And it's about firefighters, so that's something new. Vinland Saga is another hype series and apparently it's a seinen, a hardcore seinen, like people often say that this series is on the same level of Berserk, Vagabond and Dead Set something. I never read the manga but the trailers are lit and the fact that Wit Studio is working on it is enough to hype me and also I love seinen. I'm currently reading Kingdom and this shit is gold. Dr. Stone. I remember the manga was one of the most talked about series last year along with The Promised Neverland and ever since the anime was announced I was looking forward to this series because this is something new, something fresh and by the way I think I already found my new waifu. So these 3 shows could possibly be one of the greatest shows of this year. Of course Danmachi season 2 is coming this season as well and I enjoyed the first season but it's not anything crazy or spectacular. On the other hand these shows look insane. But that doesn't mean I am not excited for Danmachi season 2. Hell I am. I can't wait to see my girl Chestia again. I mean, Hestia, yes. Yes, that's what I want to say. I swear that was not on purpose. Hey, wait, who the fuck is beating the front door? Hey, stop. Hey. Finally get rid of those FBI agents. I swear I will not say anything like that anymore. I swear. But anyways, let's move on. Now there is a series in particular that I am really excited for and that is Kanada no Astra or Astra Lost in Space, which is a survival series. I don't think we have such type of series before. I have read the manga and it's really freaking good. There are only 49 chapters in total. It's a short, simple story but well executed. First few chapters might seem slow but it's all for world building and then we get plot twist after plot twist. And the series get dark and everything start to make sense. And from the trailers, it looks really good. Since it's done by Studio Lurch who are responsible for Classroom of the Elite, which by the way I really loved that series. But the adaptation was not that good. They cut a lot of content from light novels, so I'm a little bit worried. I hope they can pull it out. They can easily adapt 49 chapters in 2 cores. And the first episode is an hour long, so that's a good sign. But please Studio Lurch, don't ruin this series for God's sake. I don't know what kind of coincidence is that, but I came across this series just when I start gym. Yes, I am talking about how heavy are the dumbbells you lift. This show is filled with cultured content and thick plot, which can even give Miruthites a run for its money. Yep, I am definitely gonna watch this shit. Karakai Jozo no Takagi-sa season 2. I really love season 1, it was sweet, wholesome. Takagi-sa is definitely cute as fuck. Her voice, her smile, her laugh, her way of teasing, everything about her is great. And of course, her forehead is even bigger than Vegeta's forehead. So I'm looking forward to season 2. Isekai Cheat Magician, another shitty isekai similar to Kengan or Mago. I will probably watch the first episode to see if it's any better. Now this show. Do you love your mom and her 2-hit multi-target attacks? It is a freaking milk isekai. That's what Joey the anime man said. Not gonna lie, I was excited for this show. Not just because it's a milk isekai, but because it's something different, something weird and something worth a try. And believe me, this is not the only weirdest shit this season. I present you a loli isekai technically it's not an isekai. If it's for my daughter, I would even fight a demon lord. The brief synopsis is that this guy found a little girl in the forest and made that girl her daughter, and it's a fantasy slice of life series. But the ending of Light Level is what messed up my mind. If you don't care about the ending, then that's fine, but else you can skip to this time. Apparently both father and daughter married at the end of this series. I mean, they are not blood related, but still.
What the fuck?
There is an anime original series called Granblem or Granbelgram. I don't know how the fuck you pronounce that name, but the series by Nexus, which looks really interesting and give me vibes that it will be some messed up shit. And last but not least, Ari Furuta from Commonplace to the World's Strongest. It's another isekai, but this reminded me of Shield Hero and how he was trained by everyone. Similar case here. So I'm looking forward to what this series has to offer. But that's it when it comes to this video. I will probably watch more, it depends on the circumstances. And if so, then I will talk about those shows as well as these shows in depth in my first impression video on 2nd or 3rd week of July. So look forward to that, and do let me know in the comments if you think there are any other worth watching series this season. And I will talk to you guys later. Until then, peace.